Hi everyone, it's Dena from MiladyLeela.com. And today I have a lot of stuff to do. So I thought I would just sit here for a little bit of time. I needed to film some videos to put up on my channel. As you know, I like to bank them and I need some content. So I thought, well, I got stuff to do here. Just some little projects that I can sit and do at my desk and chit chat with you while I'm doing it. So, originally I got dressed today because I was going to run some errands outside of the cottage and take care of some business, go visit my mom, but that didn't end up happening today. I have a meeting online. It's a wine chat kind of meeting with one of my friends who I haven't seen in a long time, and I suggested coffee chat, and she said, hey, let's do a wine chat. We'll have a glass of wine together. So that's what we're going to do tonight, a little bit later after dinner. And it's super cool because we can sit in the own comfort of our own homes and have a glass of wine together, chit chat, and catch up. So we're going to do that. But in front of me, I have some little light things that need their batteries to be changed, and I have a couple Valentine's Day themed ones that I want to get ready for the holiday. One of them I'm thinking about putting in my purse, just for fun, my purse, my handbag. Lately I've been saying purse, and for a long time I was saying handbag. Truth be told, it's the same thing, but I'm in the process of changing out my handbag for Valentine's Day and doing a Valentine's Day edition. And the bag that I'm choosing to use for Valentine's Day for the month is a bag that you've seen before. It is an Ed Hardy inspired bag that says love hurts with a tattoo in the front of it. It's super cute, really, really rock and roll zebra. It's really awesome. And I'm in the process of getting that all prepared and switched out from my Juicy Couture that I've been using. Let me go grab that so I can show you. Maybe we'll do a quick little what's in my purse with the Juicy Couture bag before I switch out. But I have those projects to do. I also have this little shaker that I made for Valentine's Day. And I want to just embellish it with a little rosette. So I'm going to glue that on there. And yeah, so I'm just sitting at my desk doing some projects. Oh, I also want to put together another blessings candle, spell candle, if you will, for the holiday. Today, I believe, is February 1st. Yes. So today is Imbolc. Happy and blessed Imbolc to all of you. It is the turn of the wheel of the year that takes us between winter and the spring equinox. So it's a celebration of cleansing and out with the old, in with the new kind of thing. It's associated a lot with Besoms in old Celtic traditions, old pagan traditions, and I have created in the past some beautiful Besoms. In fact, maybe I'll go grab those as well since we're sitting here and talking about this. And I'll also grab my Juicy Couture handbag. And honestly, I did not even plan on getting into this much in this video. It was just going to be stuff to do. But be it that it is Imbolc, and I was actually thinking about preparing a video for that, this is perfect. So I shall be right back. In the meantime, take this opportunity to grab yourself your favorite cuppa. I'm having a cup of coffee. I'm also having a little snack. I have a little bit of a granola bar, and I shall be right back. Okay, everyone, I am back. And I'm super excited to share these items with you. Oh my gosh. Okay, first of all, I have two besoms to show you. And a while ago, probably about 5 or 6 years ago, I had a besom gathering with some of the girls that I worked with that were, we called ourselves the spiritual sisters. And we created besoms at my house, and this was when I lived at the castle. And I had three girls over, so there was a total of four of us, and we each made our own besoms. We were required to have ready all of our items with us and just come to my house, and we had snacks and wine, and we created these besoms. So this is the very first besom that I ever made. I love it so much. It is absolutely gorgeous. This was a cinnamon broom, and I added red roses, and I added this beautiful key, and then eucalyptus. And the symbolism here is that red roses for February, first of all, are very symbolic, and red signifies love and also passion. And then the key was basically to symbolize the key to my heart, to my hubby, and also to unlock all of the ideas and manifest the things that I wanted to manifest for that particular year. And then the eucalyptus was for healing and health, good health. And cinnamon is very symbolic of prosperity. So this was my very first besom that I ever created, and I absolutely love her. And she was kind of hanging out in my living room for a while, but I think I may keep her in the magical kitchen for Valentine's Day this year. And this was the second besom when we owned the tea shop. I had another besom gathering at the tea shop with a few ladies, and this was the second besom that I created. And these right here that I created, the broom part, were actually from roses that I had dried. So these are like the stems of all of the roses that I had dried in that particular time period that I saved for this project. And the stem is also, the actual stick of the broom is actually a rose stem as well. And then, of course, the eucalyptus to symbolize, and you're hearing my heater, by the way, the eucalyptus, again, to symbolize good health. And then I have here these adorable little blue robin's eggs to symbolize the spring and moving forward into new and beautiful things. I have a pink rose, which is symbolic of, first of all, me, because I love the color pink, and also pink is just soft and beautiful and gentle. So moving into that year, particularly with gentleness. And then I had this little crow charm that I added here, and then some fairy dusted little bottles to symbolize, the fairy dust is to symbolize my love for fairies, and just a sprinkling of glitter and a sprinkling of love and light wherever I go. And the crow is basically to bind the spell of this particular besom. So I absolutely love this too, and honestly, I can't decide now because I have some pink going on in the magical kitchen as well. So I'm going to have to, come to think of it, I have this beautiful lamp that I thrifted, and I will be sharing it with you. I've showed it before in a previous video, and it's like a vase, like a vintage vase shape with roses hand-painted on it, and it's got beautiful shades of green and gold. So I think I'm going to add the pink besom into the magical kitchen, and then I'll put the red one back in the living room for this year for Imbolc. Okay. Also, this is my Juicy Couture, beautiful vintage Juicy Couture bag that I thrifted at the Salvation Army quite a while ago. I love this bag because it has the bow features here on either side that holds little pockets, and I keep my glasses in one, and then on the other side I keep some hand sanitizer. And then it comes with this beautiful vegan leather tassel with a gold top. I love that. Gold hardware. and then it has these really nice little ribbons through the rivets. And this is what it looks like inside. I have it quite full. So it is a leopard bag, and it's like a really soft, I don't want to say it's like a, it's really not a suede, but it's like a faux suede. And it just feels so soft and lovely. And in it, the first thing that I'm going to take out is this adorable little guy. This is my little zebra that I thrifted, also at the Salvation Army. I love him so much. I like to keep him in my bag because he is just, he's really, really beautiful for kind of curbing my anxiety that sometimes I get while I'm traveling. So I like to keep him with me, and I can just kind of hold on to him and sort of, you know, close my eyes and meditate. So he's really wonderful for that, but he's also wonderful for my keychain. I've had this zebra lanyard keychain for a really long time. The handle right here is actually from a cosmetic bag that I no longer have, but I kept the handle, and I'm so glad I did. And all I do is just keep that around his neck like a collar so that I can always find my keys. I also have a vintage eyeglass case, and I keep my sunglasses in here. So I'll show you what they look like. I love them. So I keep that in here. I think my mom gave this to me. I just dropped some lights. Give me 1 second. Well, I'm really excited about this video today. I really did not intend on doing this. I probably should have did it live. I usually film it in the live section of the app, but I keep it unlisted, so I share it after. It would have been a cool live video to do, but that's okay. I'm probably going to, after I get this filmed, I'm going to go ahead and release it. I also have a adorable little pouch that I keep my headphones in with this little clip. I got both the clip and the pouch at Shoppe. And then I have my planner. I've showed this before if you join me on journal workshops, which I do live the second Monday of every month. Although, stay tuned, in the month of February, our journal workshop is going to be on the 6th, because the 13th is the second Monday, and it is our grandson's birthday, so we're going to be celebrating with him. And then the next day is our anniversary, our wedding anniversary, so I just moved it up a week. So stay tuned for that. That will be a live video at 8 p.m. On my channel. But in here, I just keep a pen, my business cards, receipts and stuff like that, and then I keep my pocket planner, which I have shared so many times. I'm not going to open it up and share it right now, but I designed this myself. I just bought a pocket planner at the Dollar Tree, and I just designed it to look like a little fairy handbook, and then I keep a little tab on it so that I can turn to the month easily, and I need to update that and move it into February, because today is February 1st. Okay, next I have my mask, and this is a zebra mask. I have a leopard one too, but that is currently being washed. No, I washed that one already, and I put it away just because I like to switch them out. So I have my zebra mask, and then I have this little pouch that I keep some gum in, and I need to add, I have another pack of gum that I need to add into it. And that goes in there. Just keeps it nice and neat. And I've talked about this so many times. This is my lovely little Kleenex pouch. And I just purchased, and I did a video on it last night. I will be releasing that soon, within the next day or so. I picked up some more little tissues to go inside. I also have a little pouch here. It's like a little coin little coin purse, and in it I keep some nail glue and some extra nails. The last set of nails that I was wearing were pink, so I have those in there in case, you know, I would break a nail or lose a nail, I could repair. So I always like to keep the set that I'm wearing, the dupe, you know, not the dupe, but the next, like the extras in my handbag so that I can always place if I need to. And then I also have some brush on glue. And it's such a pretty color of pink. Yeah, it's so hard to decide. I'm about to do my nails again. Maybe I'll do them today. Maybe even while I'm talking with Mary. I'm probably going to do red because Jimmy loves red and it is Valentine's Day coming up. So I keep my extra nails in there. And then I have another one exactly the same but in a different color, metallic. And this one is beautiful pink, and this is my change purse, so I keep all of my coins in there. And then I have a snack. It's a Belvita breakfast cookie snack. I keep that in there to munch on in case I'm out and about and I start to get a little dizzy, which you guys have been with me for a while. The ones that have know that I really need to be mindful of that because I get a little dizzy if I haven't eaten. And by the way, if you're new to my channel and you stumbled across this video, welcome. Thank you for being here. And those of you that have been with me, thank you for coming back. So I love you guys so much. I hope that you'll subscribe, hit that little bell as well, and the notification, you know, the notification bell so you don't miss a single upload every time I post. Also have a compact with a little puff to apply, and I love this. This is a Color Mates pressed powder in the color Rose Beige. This is what it looks like. And this little puff has this cute little thing for your fingers, and I love it so much. It's from Chat-Miladyleela. And I love the fact that you can kind of maneuver it in your fingers and powder your face when you need to. Okay, I also have my little medicine silver pouch. And in here, I just added for Valentine's Day, I put my, I was going to put my Aleve in here. And I'm probably going to do that just to consolidate more. But I currently have some Mucinex in here. And then I have this little antique medicine box that I keep Jimmy's medication in so that he always has that. Then I have my Aleve. I have some hair twisties in here. I have some bubbles. Always gotta have bubbles. I have my little natural medicine tin, which houses some crystals and some oils. And this is a bottle of Dramamine. I don't have anything in it right now. Oh, yes, I do. Yes, I do. It's for nausea, obviously, but I also keep my little anxiety things in here. I take this medication that is like a, it's a broad spectrum medication, and it covers allergy issues as well as it helps curb anxiety. It's non-addictive. It's really a great medication. And I'm trying to think what it's called. I think it's called Visceral. Visceral. I'm going to go check. I'm going to check for you guys. Yeah, because it's non-addictive, which is really, really nice. And
Oh my. Well, you guys.
I guess I'm out of it. I need to get it refilled. But I'm pretty sure it's called Visceral. And, no shame, you know? Like, it's really wonderful because I suffer with chronic allergies, as you guys all know. And I just feel like... Well, Dramamine is also like a, it does help with nausea, but it also helps with anxiety too, believe it or not. And that's over the counter. You can just get that over the counter. This is not a medical thing, you guys. So honestly, I don't even know why I'm getting into this. Disclaimer here. This is just what I do. So I'm not telling you to take anything, specific. I'm just telling you that, you know, like a lot of people talk about like different things like CBD gummies and stuff like that. I'm not using those because these seem to really work for me, and like I said, it's non-addictive and it helps with my allergies, so it's really, really wonderful. And I honestly take less a day than what my prescription says that I'm able to take, so I just take extra with me in the event that I end up getting a panic attack. And this will help. So I carry it with me just in case. It's always better to have it and not need it than need it and not have it, right? That is Jimmy's famous line. So I have that. Again, disclaimer, you guys, this is just like what I do. So I'm thinking about putting my Aleve in my little heart. Because it's super cute. And this was like the little bottle. I think it was a little travel bottle of some sort. But I'm going to put my Aleve in here too. And I also have my Mucinex. Again, my allergies like are popping a lot of times. So now I've got my medication in this adorable little heart. Okay. So, yeah. This is the little medicine bag. The ones that I love the most, though, are my natural medications for anxiety, and that is my oils. I just love this. And this tin, by the way, was gifted to me by my mill. All right. Enough of that. Oh, my gosh. Okay. Next. This is a Daisy Rose. I'm pretty sure that's what it's called. Yeah, Daisy Rose. Little card case. I love this. I keep all my cards in here, and I usually keep cash folded in here too whenever I have cash on me. But this is really slim and it's beautiful within my bag. So I also have this adorable little Hello Kitty pouch that I got from Shop Miss A, and in it I keep my essentials that I'm using daily. So I have my rose lip oil. I've been using pink lipstick for the last several days, so I have a pink liner, and this is Wet n Wild gel lip liner in the color Perfect Pout. Pretty sure that's what it's called. This is what it looks like. Yeah. It's hard to see, but yeah, it's pink. It's pretty. And then the lipstick is Revlon Matte Stormy Pink. Color number 011. Beautiful. I love it. And then I have a not a retractable. It's just like a travel lip brush. I have an eyelash glue. I have a chapstick, regular formula. And I have a vintage Sweet Honesty rollerball perfume and a bobby pin. So that's what I keep in there. Okay, and then this is what it looks like inside. It says Juicy Couture on the zipper pouch. And then in that little pouch, I keep my Glasses for evening driving if I need them, which I don't drive typically that often at night, but sometimes I need to when I do. I'll have the glasses just in case. It's one of those things like it's better to have them and not need them than to need them and not have them. It just really helps with the glare sometimes. And then I also have my inhaler because I have seasonal asthma. So yeah, I could put that in my little medicine pouch actually now that I've consolidated. So I think I'm going to do that. And that'll all my medicines in one spot. Okay, so then I'll load the pouch or the handbag back up because it just makes my life so much easier to know that everything is put away. It's kind of like a little tip for you guys too. A little tip that I've learned is that when you do something on a regular basis for at least a month, it comes habitual. And therefore, if you put things away, for example, like your clothing, things that you've taken out from a specific spot, you put it back where it belongs right away. Or like, for example, if you're working in your kitchen and then you're done preparing your food and you start, you know, before you clean up your dishes, you put your utensils and things away that you've used, you clean them and put them away. It just, you get into a routine and it really works. Here's a classic example, not only about just putting everything away while I'm talking to you and doing that. My wardrobe room is so much more nice. And by the way, I've talked about this before in the last video I filmed. I do want to do a haul of the room, not a haul, a tour. But already I'm thinking about changing it up. So I'm not sure if I'm going to do that and then do the haul or, not haul, tour, or if I'm going to change it up later and do the tour first. I don't know. We'll see. It just depends on what I have time for because I talked about how my time is really limited, but my wardrobe is so much neater now than my studio is. I have a nook, studio nook in my wardrobe. That's neat now. My wardrobe's neat. You know, and just that habit of putting things away just really makes a difference. So you can feel so wonderful and cozy and beautiful in your space and enveloped, but not overwhelmed or like not enveloped by a bunch of clutter or overwhelmed by a bunch of clutter. But enveloped by all of the beautiful things that you love. And yes, I've said before, I am a maximalist. I am not a minimalist. I have a lot of things. That everything is strategically placed. I love each and every one that I have of my pieces that I've kept from the move, especially coming to this house and the things that I've collected since I've been here. And it just really makes a difference. And one of the most interesting habits that I found recently that I just thought about was I used to never be a slipper wearer. I loved slippers and I had them, but I never really wore them. I would always walk around barefoot, stub my toe, step on something. Jimmy, on the other hand, was always wearing slippers. And he goes, why don't you just start wearing your slippers? So I forced myself to wear my slippers. And now when I don't have my slippers on, I feel so weird without them. Yes, I still love to be barefoot, and I do that as well. But I notice now, my hair's caught in my ring. I notice now that I don't have my slippers on. And another thing that I have discovered, that I discovered this quite a while ago, when we lived here at the cottage, when it was my Mill's home, and we were taking care of her, I used to always clean up in the kitchen immediately every night after dinner. I would basically clean the kitchen up so that I could, quote unquote, put it to bed. Therefore, waking up the next morning and having a beautiful kitchen to look forward to my first cup of coffee in the morning and not feel overwhelmed with dishes and things out. When we lived over at the castle, I'm not saying that my kitchen was dirty or messy, but I kind of let it go. And I was like, oh, I'll get to it tomorrow kind of thing. Well, I formed a habit in living here and taking care of my Mill. And now that it's our home. And I've been doing it now going on 3 years because we lived here for 2 years prior. And then we've lived here a year as it being our own cottage after my mill's passing. My kitchen is clean every single day. And I walk into a beautiful, amazing vintage kitchen every single morning. My kitchen is clean. My countertops look amazing. And it just feels so good. So it's just something that you can start doing. And it really helps. All right. I'm going to take a little bite of my breakfast bar. The next thing I want to do is get these battery packs ready. Okay. So this right here, super cute. I actually bought this a couple years ago at the Dollar Tree. I haven't seen it there since. And where did I put that? Oh. I also bought this at the Dollar Tree many years ago. I think they still have these. This is a little glasses kit, but I love it because it has the tiny little screwdrivers that also open up your battery packs. So I bought this adorable heart-shaped battery pack light kit for my mill. She loved lights. And when she was with us, this brings back so many beautiful memories. She loved lights so much. And when we first started taking care of her, she was, what do you call it, ambulatory, where she was able to walk around, but she used a walker. So I would decorate her walker. I would wrap lights all around it, and I would put Valentine hearts around it. And she loved that. I'd decorate her room where she was staying. And yeah. So that's what these are from. And I love them. And they're big. And what I like about them as compared to these little hearts. Now, they might carry these now. I got these also like a year or so ago. But I've seen during the different seasons these like really bendable, pliable wire kind of lights with the little seasonal decor on it. So what I like about these though is this is like the regular kind of Christmas tree wire, if you will. I'm planning on putting these in my handbag, my Valentine's handbag that I'm talking about with the Ed Hardy dupe. Just so that when I look inside my handbag at night, I can light it up and it's going to be cute. And if I put this in there, these wires would get all messed up. So probably what I'm going to do with this is just either use it around the house or maybe use it like around our tip jar for the band. More than likely, I'll use it around the house because I really don't want it to get messed up. We throw things in and out of our van, moving equipment from the van to the gig, from the gig back to the van, and I don't want these to get destroyed. So I'll probably keep them for the house, but I want to use these for my handbag. And you guys, I'm going to be doing another video today, and I'm going to share with you some ideas of items that you can purchase for Valentine's Day. And one of the things that I'm going to share with you is a beautiful weekender bag that Jimmy got me for Valentine's Day. And I picked it out. Those of you that have been with me know that I do that. I pick things out that I want so that he, you know, doesn't have to search for stuff and possibly find something that I didn't want or like. So I can't wait to share it with you because that bag, it's a really cute weekender, and I use a weekender when I go to, you know, for gigs. This particular one that he just got me, I won't be using for gigs, only because it would get dirty very quick. Just kind of like the idea of the lights that I was just telling you about. And I don't want it to get dirty. So what I'm going to use that for is whenever I'm going somewhere where we're going to be for a while, like if we go to the studio or we're going to a friend's house and we're going to be there for like many hours and I want to take a bunch of stuff with me and not inundate my handbag with, I will take that as like an extra bag weekender kind of thing just to throw things in that I need, you know, like my projects that I'm working on, a collage project, a knitting project, you know, something, anything that I'm working on, that my Chromebook, you know, things that are a little bit larger that I don't want to throw into my handbag and inundate it with other stuff, but I need for the day, so I will take that. And right now what I'm doing is actually removing the batteries and opening the battery packs so I can add more batteries. I'm not going to put the batteries in while I'm filming this video with you. I will do that after because the next thing I want to share with you is the blessings candle that I'm going to be making. Now, if you are interested in my blessings candles, I just created one for Christmas. And all you need to type in, I've also done other ones, so all you need to do is type into my channel or type into YouTube search bar, Miladyleela spell candle or spell / blessings candle, and you will find it. You will find how I did them. And you can basically put your own spin to each and every one that you are going to make. This particular one that I want to make today with you, I'm not going to get into the herbal part of it because I don't have that prepared or with me at the moment. So that would basically take way too much time to go grab those things. But I will talk to you about what I'm going to do. Before I get into that, I also want to show you my lovely desk planner for 2023. I talk about this every time we do a journal workshop and share with you the newest and current pages. I'm just super excited about this. I do a lot of collaging in this. Just kind of show you a little bit here. I still have to do this right here. I'm planning on putting, join me for journal workshops and you'll see more. But I'm planning on putting this, which is a die cut that I just cut out, at the bottom underneath my picture and adding some flowers to it, making like a little scene. But like here's the floating pocket that I created. I love this so much. This is just one of those envelopes that you get in the mail and that has the little open window, and I am keeping it. I made a little floating pocket is what they're called, so you can move them from place to place within your books. And I just collaged on it, painted on it, and that cute little deer thing you see inside in the window is an invitation that I got to a baby shower that took place in January. So just to keep these things for the year and keep them in my inspiration memory planner. And then this adorable little pink ruffled piece right here is a ruffle that I made out of crepe paper. And I just love that. So I talk a lot more about how to make those things in journal workshops, but you know, I have vision boards in here and I have monthly tabs and all kinds of writing, collaging. I'm not really going to get too much into it. I put a calendar in here, and then of course, as you can see, I've also created little planner clips. I have these little gumballs, and these are not gumballs. These are little styrofoam pieces that I got. They're table scatter from the Dollar Tree, and then I made this adorable little bear clip as well. By the way, I do have my planner clips available for purchase, so if anybody's interested, just leave me a comment below and let me know. Okay, so getting into the blessings candle. I purchased this candle at the Dollar Tree, and I got the color pink because, again, I talked about this in the Besom that I shared with you. The color pink is my favorite color, first of all. It's perfect for Valentine's Day for the season of the month of February, as well as red. But I did a red candle for Christmas. I wanted to do a pink for Imbolc Valentine's Day month. And also, the color pink, as I said, symbolizes gentleness and softness. And I want to move in and ease into the new year and manifest everything that I need and want slowly and gently without stress. So pink is a color for that. I love getting these jar candles because they are 7-day jar candles. For example, you see these in a lot of churches. You light them and they will literally burn for 7 days. That's why they're called 7-day candles. They're perfect for saying prayers. They're definitely sold as prayer candles, but you can use them for whatever. But I use them for prayer blessings, spell candles, if you will. And I also kind of mix it up and create my own way about it. And what I mean by that is I will then take a wooden skewer and I will do the four quarters and then five, the fifth one being spirit. So I will do earth, air, fire, water, and spirit with a wooden skewer. And I bring that all the way down to the bottom of the candle. And then I fill it with oils, essential oils, that represent the blessings, prayer, and or spell that I am trying to put forth into the candle. Then I sprinkle it with a few different herbs very carefully and lightly, and then I melt down other wax to seal it, and then I add just a little bit, while the wax is still wet, a little bit more of the herb mixture, and I sprinkle it with, of course, fairy dust, which, as you know, fairy dust meaning my beautiful glitters that I have. And that, my friends, is how I make a spell jar blessings prayer candle. So I'm going to have to retitle this title of this video. So what I'm going to do, I also like to add an image to the front. And usually I add some sort of a beautiful goddess or maybe a picture of a Besom or whatever for this time of year. But instead, I have decided to use this image right here, which I found online. And then I just tore it because I like that look. And I could, if I wanted to, age it a little bit. I'm probably going to do that by using some inks here at the top. And then I wanted to show you also. Oh, I don't have my phone in here with me, but I also printed out, I have a clear phone cover, and excuse me, I printed this out in a smaller size as well and trimmed it to fit inside my phone for the month of February. So that is what I'm going to be doing. I don't think I have any inks here. So So I'm going to go grab, do I want to age it? Let me see. I don't know. It's so pretty just the way it is. What you could do is you could tea stain your image if you wanted to. Oh, I know what I'm going to do. And we're going to do this together. I am going to line the edges in cinnamon. So let me get that ready. And as I said before, cinnamon is a symbolic herb to bringing in prosperity. So I'm going to get a paper towel. I have a paper towel and I have my cinnamon spice, and I'm just going to grab a little bit of glue because, you know, if you used water, it would just basically stain it. I want to not only stain it, the edges, I want to have it there, almost like a little glitter kind of thing. So I'm just, what I'm doing is, I'm just adding the cinnamon onto my paper towel, and then I have, this glue is really made for collage, but I love it because it works for so many different things. It's my favorite glue. It's Elmer's rubber cement, so I'm just going to carefully line the edge, and then tap it in to the cinnamon. As you can see, it's hard to see. It's really difficult to see, but you can see a little bit there in the lighting. And then it kind of just gives it that little bit of an aged look. You want to go very sparingly with your glue and do one section at a time. And this is only if you choose to do this with an image. This is just the way I'm making this today. You don't necessarily have to do it like this. Oh, I love that. A little bit more here. Two more edges. I've been wanting to do this project with you for so long, and I just really haven't had the time. And like I said, today we were supposed to go visit my mom, and plans got changed. So I figured I would take the opportunity to do some filming. Now, I mentioned about journal workshops. I also have a group on Facebook. My journal workshops are free on YouTube once a month. Like I said, the second Monday of every single month. But this month for February 2023, it's going to be on the 6th, which is the first Monday. But I do have a group on Facebook, and the group is kind of like a membership club where it's $25. And that is a lifetime membership. And if you're interested in that, we share a lot more in the group. And for example, like if you wanted some of my die cuts or some printables that I found online, you know, just really, yeah, you could find them, for example, online, some of the things that I'm sharing that are from online. But you know, I mean, it saves you a lot of time because I'm doing all the legwork. So for $25, there is actually, the group's been there for about 4 years. There is so much information. You could just spend hours and hours scrolling down and getting information of the what's in the group. And everybody in the group is so nice and so friendly. So it's $25 to join. It's a lifetime membership. And if you're interested in that, let me know in the comments. And you can go ahead and deposit your $25 via PayPal. My link to PayPal is there. It's paypal.me/miladyleela. And but like I said, please let me know that you're paying for the journal workshop. Okay. So, I have this all done. The journal workshop group, excuse me. Now, the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to glue the back. Of the piece of paper. So that I can adhere it onto my spell candle. Prayer, blessings, spell. All the same. Okay. So now I have that coated. And I'm going to pick a side of the candle that I want to have it covered. And usually in these candles, you will find some bubble-like through the glass. It's not really a bubble where there's no wax. It's just kind of the way the candle went and the, you know, where it's positioned inside the jar of the wax. So I would like to cover that part. And so I'm just going to place my candle like this down on my table and place my image and then make sure it's glued really well. I have to add a little bit of extra glue on the sides. You know, and this glue might not be the right glue for you. You might want to use Elmer's glue or, you know, some kind of PVA glue. I just have this on hand at my desk. And then what you can do also after you get it glued on, I would recommend, especially if you'd like to keep this prayer candle as a vessel after the candle burns. And what I mean by that is once the candle has burned down, you can reuse it. How I do that is, and I've done this with many of the candles that I've created like this, is after the candle burns down, I fill the vessel up with salt. Symbolism behind that is salt is very protective. Protects your blessing, protects your prayer. And it also creates height within the vessel so that you can drop a little tea light candle down onto and then light your tea light candle and you will still be able to use it as a vessel, particularly if you put a lot of time into the imagery on the front. So that's what it looks like. And what I think I'm going to do next with this before I add my herbs and oils is I'm going to take some Mod Podge and seal my candle onto the jar with Mod Podge. I'm not going to do that now because it just would take too much time, and I'd have to get up and get that, and I don't have it handy. So I'm very excited about that because I want to get this done so that I can light it before midnight. Probably should have done this yesterday, but I really didn't get a chance to do it, so I did it today. But anyhow, there you have it, and look how gorgeous this looks. So pretty, so cute with the little animals, Valentine's Day themed, perfect for the season, perfect for Valentine's Day, perfect for love blessings, perfect for new beginnings. Anything, any intention that you want to put into it is the perfect candle. And I love pink because pink helps you to move forward gently. Red would be if you want to move forward with passion. So either way, however you want to do it. But there you have it. I think I'm going to end this video now and move on to the next video that I want to share with you with the Valentine's Day ideas and a few DIYs, I think. Anyhow, yeah. So I hope you enjoy this video. As said, please subscribe if you haven't done so already. Thank you for being here. I appreciate each and every one of you and your time. No matter where you are in the world, thank you so much for hanging out with me. And if you like this video, please share it with your friends and family and followers whom you think might enjoy my content. That would make me so happy to continue to spread love and light around the globe with all of us helping each other out in order to do that here on my channel would be a beautiful thing. So I wish you so much love, many, many blessings, and many friendships to come. And I'll see you all in the next video.